Now we've come here in verse 4 of chapter 15 to a new section. Now Paul begins to talk about the fact that Jews and Gentiles in one body are there to glorify God. And what we have here in verse 4 is this: for whatsoever things were written aforetime were written for our learning, that we through patience and comfort of the Scriptures might have hope. Now, the Old Testament, therefore, does have a definite application to believers today. Now, if you've listened to our program, you know I've shared letters from time to time of folk who wrote, and the sense of the letter was this: I never knew that the Old Testament was so practical. I never knew that it had such meaning for us today. I never knew that it spoke of Christ as it does. Well, the Old Testament, you see, is for our comfort. And Paul says here, these things were written in the old time for our learning. And I would say the greatest sin in the church today of Jesus Christ is ignorance of the Word of God. And I think it's tragic, and I've heard this so many times. A deacon says, "Well, you know, I don't know much about the Bible." Why don't you? These things were written for time for your learning. God wants you to know His Word. You mean that you can boast as a deacon of the church that you're ignorant of the Word of God? You mean that you occupy an office in the church, or that you are busy in the church, that you are doing things in the church and you're ignorant of the Word of God? Well, you better get busy. I think that's the great sin of the hour. Now, Paul says these things were written for your learning. And what will it do for you? Well, that through patience and comfort of the Scriptures, the only way in the world that you can find any comfort today in this world and any patience today is in the Scriptures. And the only place that you're going to find any hope, you won't find any hope in the papers. You don't find any hope in modern literature today. Look at modern art. Look in any field today and see if you see any hope. Listen to modern music, my friend. Is there any hope today? None whatsoever. It's dark and dismal when you look out at this world. The only place you can find hope is in the Word of God. I think that one of the most interesting things is I was up in the state of Washington, and it rained and rained and rained, and then it rained some more. Oh, I tell you, how dark and dismal the days were. Then we went over to the airport. It's still raining. And we got on the plane, and the plane took off, went up through all those clouds, and in a few moments we just broke out into the light, and the sun was shining up there. Oh, how beautiful it was. And less than a mile up, the sun was shining. And here we were living like a bunch of gophers down there in all of that rain. Now, my friend, don't misunderstand me, because people in Washington are going to hear this program, and I'm going to hear from them. But very frankly, they need all that rain up there for those beautiful, lovely trees. But I've been in Southern California too long. I love the sunshine. And it was wonderful to get up there. Now, there are a great many Christians today that are staying down here beneath the cloud. The Lord says, come on up here where the sunshine of hope is shining today. And that's what the Bible will do for you. It's the only thing that will do this for you, my friend. Now, you'll notice here, he says that in 1 Corinthians 10, he says, now all these things happened unto them for ensamples. And they're written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the world are come. Now, when we were studying about David, I got more letters from folk, and I met more people that said, oh, what an encouragement, what a help to me David was. And one party said to me, they were going through a very dark period in their life. They said, that came at the right moment. It delivered me probably from suicide about David. Well, that's the reason God wrote that, friends. After all, He put David's sin on display. That wasn't very nice. But God, you know, paints mankind just as He is. But that was written for our learning. Everything in the Old Testament, friends, is written for our learning and to give us patience and to give us comfort. and bring hope into our lives. That's the purpose.